Okay, this is going to be your reading for All Science Collective, almost personal, so all that I need to know. So let's see, for the next 72 hours, all that my dear soulmate twin flames need to know about their connection, where things are going. My sister is doing well, by the way. Thanks for all your prayers. However, my cousin brother and my uncle has been sick all day today and they've been admitted. So, you know, family thing has been kind of a little messed up. Hopeful that things are going to be okay. So let's start with you guys. So it's all coming up for you. So let's take your energy first and then moving on to the energy. This is a new deck today. Okay, with Wheel of Fortune, your emotions are a bit on and off. Okay, some days you feel like this connection is still on and some days you feel like no, you know, like nothing is going to come out of it. So you are kind of having mix of emotion, mix of feelings, and you are kind of going on and off, you know, like a pendulum. Like some days you feel like, oh my god, this is still on, and some days you're like, nah, it's off, you know. So one more card. So what else do we see coming up in your life? So mix of emotions is what I see. Okay, second card we have is the Magician card. Many of you guys are still trying to be hopeful towards the future, towards something new coming in your life, towards manifesting. Many of you guys are going to want to see that what all you could manifest in your life, new things, obviously. In the recent past, I see you doing nothing. I see you just holding on. I just see you wanting to see what your person is up to. New or old, you are just holding on. Like, I don't see you trying harder, to be honest. You are just waiting on them. So let's see what else is coming up in your life. The next 72 hours, please. Okay. With Six of Swords in the reverse, I believe completely you are not being able to let go of this connection. 100% not there. I would say almost 40-50% there, but 50% still remains. Okay. So in the past, I believe some of you guys were stalking or keeping a watch or just wanting to see what your person is up to. You were a bit curious about this connection, about this person. Okay. What else do we see happening in your connection for the next 72 hours? Soulmate twin flames, all that you need to know. Okay, with Five of Swords, it's like clash of the ego, clash of the two people's egos, okay, where you guys are waiting on them and they are waiting on you, neither of which are, you know, initiating the conversation. You know, you guys are not taking action and both are waiting on each other to make the first move. So both are wanting to prove to their ego that, you know, the other person will message me. You know, I am going to wait on this person. They will message me and you're still waiting. You both are still waiting on each other's message. And that's been going on. So fight of the ego. Okay. So one more card. In terms of your person, what are they going through? In terms of your person, what are they going through? Okay, this person, I believe, is a bit restless, but they might not be showing that to you. With Two of Wands, they've been at crossroads, and they've maintained that crossroads, you know? They haven't been taking action, okay? I believe they are watching you. They are also restless on you, but they are not showing anything. They are not saying anything. They are not behaving that way, okay? One more card. In terms of how thinking about you now, how they're truly thinking about you. With Ace of Swords, I believe many of them are trying to connect with you, trying to communicate with you, trying to speak to you, I'm not saying they will, trying to. One more card. In terms of their energy towards you, what's their energy towards you, please? Energy towards you is Nine of Cups. I know you're going to hate me for saying this. Even if they are confused regarding this connection, they still want this. This is what makes them happy. Ace of Swords, Nine of Cups. Their wish is to reconnect with you. Okay, they really wish to talk to you, to converse with you, to have a you know, some sort of dialogue with you. Okay, one more card. In terms of how do they view the connection now? In terms of how do they view the connection? Queen of Wands, they are still very interested towards this connection. They still have passion for this connection. So in terms of that attraction, passion, wanting, they still have an interest towards it. What's bothering them is Seven of Cups. confusion or more than one people involved on either side, I believe is confusing the connection. Okay, one more card. In terms of what do they have to offer now? What do they have to offer, please? Knight of Pentacles, slow moving deck, slow moving card. Okay, so I believe that this person, even if they are coming forward, they are going to bore the shit out of you. Okay, I know you guys are screaming out that this they've just been boring and nothing else. Okay, but they have behaved that way. You know, they haven't taken any sort of fast action, and sometimes you even question yourself whether they are still even interested. You know, with the Knight of Pentacles here being the slowest card ever, this person has been taking baby steps, and sometimes it's not noticeable that this person is even interested sometimes, you know. So yeah, that has been going on. Okay, so what happened, what they have to offer is this still the slow moving connection where they do not take fast steps, rather they take calculated steps, you know, where they don't want to lose, they don't want to feel like, you know, they are wasting their time. So they'll think about it before coming forward. Okay, one more card. For what do they have in their mind right now regarding this connection? What do they have in their mind? What they have? Okay. For some while they've been distancing from you, or staying like at a safe distance, maintaining distance, ghosting you. Even if you approach them, they are not really giving you any sort of idea as to what is happening in their life. Okay, the Hermit and Seven of Wands is both distancing card. Some of you, they might feel you're doing this, like you're ghosting them or you're maintaining distance. But I believe if you have reached out quite recently, or you have had some bits of communication, then I believe this person hasn't been very open. Like, they might have replied, but not the type of conversation you'd want from them. Very shabby, very non-emotional shit. Like, you know, what's going on, how's this, how's that. Nothing about the connection, nothing about feelings, and nothing about the future. Okay, just practical shit. Okay, one card for their current feelings towards you. How do they truly feel for you? King of Pentacles. Why is the King of Pentacles your spirit? Sun card. Sometimes they do think of what if they look forward towards commitment with you. What if they look forward towards something solid, something long term. Okay, but the problem has always been that, you know, they have never been putting in effort with Six of Pentacles in the reverse. You have always been the one that's been there. Okay, like that's been always doing everything it takes to keep this connection going. Okay, so I believe with Sun and King of Pentacles, this person is definitely looking forward to it. Okay, you're definitely the types they'd want to end up with. But are they still wanting to get fixed? Are they still wanting to, you know, let go of all the options and choose you? You're definitely the marriage, types, like, spouse types. But are they still wanting to let go of the third parties completely? That is the question. Okay, I don't, question or doubt your worth. I mean, you're definitely worth being a partner for life. But the third parties that they have been putting you into, that should get away, right? So that's the problem. That has been the problem. Okay, they want to have fun, but at the same time, they don't want to let go of you either. So yeah, one more card. In terms of their heart space, what's happening in terms of their heart space? In terms of their heart space, trust me or not, they are still stuck on you. Sorry. Okay, I've been eating words lately. But with the Hangman, they are still very much stuck on you. They haven't taken any action. Hangman is not a card of action. It's rather a card where someone is just surrendered to the possibility that, yes, I still love you, but I'm not going to shit about it. You know? So that's been their attitude towards this whole situation. One more card. In terms of their hate space, what's going on? In terms of their hate space. In terms of their headspace with the Moon card, they don't know what to do. Okay, like sometimes they know that this is the connection, this you are their person, that you are someone that means a lot, but they are not ready to express that. They are not ready to open up about their feelings. Okay, but what are they looking forward to have with you in terms of intentions? So what are their true intentions towards you, please? See, they still want to control you, darling. Okay, they still want to have control over the situation. They haven't been very much supportive, balanced, nothing like that. They still want control. And if you don't give them control, they just don't want to, you know, invest. You know, they want control, and that is what they look forward to. One more card in terms of what action I want to take towards you, please. Queen of Swords. You can expect communication, but not the type of communication you're wanting. So very much controlling, very much dominating, very much coming off as someone who is non-emotional, detached as fuck, behaving like someone who doesn't really care much, doesn't really have much in terms of emotions I'm talking about, and behaving very much unbothered. Okay, yeah, so I'm going to talk to you, but you know, I'm not going to show you my emotions whatsoever, that sort of attitude. Okay, one card for what can you expect out of them. One more card, please. Okay. So to be honest, they haven't been able to let go of you completely with the Eight of Cups in the reverse. Even if they have been distancing themselves from you, they won't be able to. With Eight of Wands, expect messages, but for a couple of days, it may look like a breakup, but it isn't a breakup. Okay. So one card for where this connection is going. Where do we see this connection going? Card just flew off. Ten of Wands. It is still difficult, it is still messed up, it is still full of drama, and it is something that is so heavy that it burdens you rather than makes you happy. Top card we have is Page of Cups. Yes, they might kind of pretentiously try to get a reaction out of you, but I still see it being heavy, still being burdensome, still being problematic. So please be careful. This person might try to come off sweet to just to keep you hanging. But to be very honest, I still see this connection being a pain in your ass. Okay, so yeah. So what else should you be knowing about this connection? What else should you be knowing about this connection? And your person. Okay. So expect positive change. One more card in terms of their person split. What do we see? Second card we have wear and tear, too painful drama. Just like I told you, where it's going, it's still Ten of Wands. It's still full of drama. It's still on and off. It's still heavy. It's still problematic. In terms of what can you look forward to? And this person is keeping secrets, just like I told you with the Moon card, half truth. So they might come off not still wanting to tell you whatever is happening, still coming off with half truths. Okay, so yes, last card we have for you, not over holding back. That's been the Hanged Man in the heart space. Hanged Man, so not over, but still holding back, still not doing shit about it. So yes, this has all been going on. Okay, and this is all I have for you for almost personal. Mind you, I have a lot of shit going on in my personal life right now, so I am not being able to do other signs on the time I was supposed to give them. So expect them in like a couple of days late, but I'm going to do all signs, all 12 of them, and all those personal readings, they have been delayed for 2-3 days. I'm really sorry, but I'm going through a lot, to be honest, you know, on a personal level, emotional level. So if you've been booking a personal, or you have booked a personal reading, please expect a couple of days late. I hope you understand my situation here. I don't want to do them being in this energy. So I want to do them when I'm really connected, right? So yes, sorry for, the late reading. And all those who want a Libra extended, I've done that. Okay, almost personal Libra extended. People do ask me, you know, why you post so much about Libras. And problem is Libras have always been so supportive. Most of my views are Libra, Scorpio, Sagittarius. So, you know, sometimes it's good business as well. So, you know, it was a Libra channel previously, which I've later transformed to all 12 Zodiac and Twin Flame. So, yes. Thank you for all your support so far. I hope I will be able to connect with you soon. And yeah, God bless you all. And all those who in India, please stay safe. It's fucked up out there, you know. So please take good care of yourself and don't take COVID for granted. Cheers.